Welcome back to our German episode of Local Flavor. I actually ate more soup than I thought I would, but there's always room for cookies, right?
That's right.
Now, what was the name of these cookies you're going to teach us to make?
We're going to make Spitzbuben.
And I'm just going to, you have pre-measured a lot of ingredients. This is yes. Like a pound of butter.
Literally, a pound of unsalted butter.
Will I embarrass myself if I say I have never heard of Spitzbuben before?
I don't think you will. A lot of people don't. It is a German cookie. Spitz literally means points, so they are a diamond-shaped cookie, kind of a pastry type, almost pie crust. They're obviously rich with all the butter that's going to be in them. And we're going to sandwich them up and powder sugar them and put jam in between them or jelly of whatever flavor we choose, and they'll be like little mini pies almost.
Now that's interesting. Spitzbuben is not a name that sounds very tasty, but I mean, because I don't know German, it sounds like,
hey, I can't
spit or something. So
I can't say that I know German very well either, however. So we're going to start with the butter. We have 4 cups of flour already measured out. The only sugar that goes in is 1 cup of just your plain old granulated sugar.
And question, does it matter what order I put them in?
No, I usually just put everything in and start the mixer.
Is it possible this recipe has no egg?
It's true, okay. No eggs in it at all. So that means you can always taste the batter and it's healthy for you.
Okay.
You don't have to worry about raw
We're
eggs
always
being
looking
in
for cookie dough that's
cookie
safe.
Cookie batter you can eat, there you go, this is it.
I saw someone post that somebody actually died from eating raw cookie dough. And I was like, oh, they tell you that, but I didn't know it really happened. But I don't know. It didn't deter me very much. I mean, I'll think about it.
Yeah, I think I still would too.
Well, so since a regular cookie usually starts with the butter then the sugar, I'll do that.
Okay.
And then I'm going to put vanilla next just because that's
It's 1 teaspoon of vanilla. I can grab this for me.
Is that pretty too loud? Am I going too fast?
No, it looks good. It's a pretty stiff dough. So by the end, it's going to take all of the power of this KitchenAid to get it mixed up.
Oh, no. Now, question, was that real butter?
That is real butter, unsalted.
Okay. And you let it set out so it'd be easy.
That's right. I didn't say that. Good point. I did leave it set out at room temperature for a while, so it was more softer.
Okay, this is going to be a mess, isn't it? We need the pour shield.
Yeah, I don't have one of those, sorry, but you're right. It does poof out a little bit with the flour.
It does even with a pour shield.
Oh, does it?
Yeah.
You have to unlock it. There we go.
I'll just add it so it...
So we get it all at once.
Yeah. I think if I go slow enough sometimes it will... Depends on where it hits it.
Yeah, see?
It's a defect in the design of these KitchenAids, my only complaint.
It does come out fast.
I have one too. Mine's blue.
The thing, the flour does make it stiffen faster, so that's where it's going to need the power of the KitchenAid. You might turn it up. There you go. Because it starts to really get it grinding.
I'm starting to get a little moist anyway. I need a little bit of powder.
So. In your face.
It'll be just like having a makeup guy.
Yeah, just throw it all in and we'll...
Are you serious? Okay. It will be a mess. This is how much? 4 cups?
4 cups, yes.
Look at that. We're going to have to hose down the whole kitchen. Okay, now after this dough is made, do we just start rolling it out or?
No, after the dough is made, it is a little crumbly, so we're going to put it in the fridge and let it chill.
And then like the moisture will work through it,
right.
Maybe?
Right, it'll be a lot easier to roll.
Uh-oh.
Ah, that's good. It'll still work. It's kind of doing a giddy-up thing there.
I gotta lock the head. I thought I locked
it. Lock it down.
Hold on. Yeah.
There we go.
I can't do it.
Fit.
Fix it.
Let's see. I'm gonna take this out. Get some of that work down in there again. So we get all of the flour.
I hope I didn't break her KitchenAid.
Oh, no.
I think they're just pretty let it tough. Go too long and it's underneath it.
They're pretty tough. Because I don't know how far, if you guys can see, it's starting to ball up more now into like one ball dough.
I don't know if they'll be able
dough
to
ball.
See it.
Probably not.
But have you already got some cooled? Should I start on the stuff that's already cooled, maybe?
Yeah, we can shut that off so you can hear us a little better.
Okay.
We have a portion of it right here that we had in the fridge set out a little bit to...
Wait a minute. This is not as much, I mean,
no.
It shrunk this much?
No, did not shrink. I like to work with it in smaller portions so it's easier to handle.
Well, I will start rolling it out. How thin do I need to get it?
We look for the thinner the better, about a quarter of an inch, give or take. So I can move this back so you have some room there.
You know what? I will start this, but it is stiff dough, like you said. Like,
yes, it is pretty stiff.
Let me start it. This is going to take a while. Okay, let's take a break and get this rolled out. And then when we come back, it will make it look like it was really easy. So we'll get this rolled out and come back and cut the cookies for you.
Hey, Next Tech customer. We all know that watching TV at home is great, but did you know that you can take your TV on the road with you with TV Everywhere? There are nearly 30 channels to choose from. Watch American Pickers on History, news on Fox News, movies on Lifetime, whatever you want. TV Everywhere is another great feature for Next Tech TV customers. Visit nexttech.com/TV Everywhere to register. Next Tech, our products and our people are here for you.
At Next Tech Wireless, we know you're always on the move and your devices go with you. That's why Next Tech Wireless has expanded its partnership with Sprint and is one of the first companies in the nation to share connectivity to Sprint's 4G LTE network. Now you can connect in more places than ever. And with the best rates, carryover data, and programs like our buyback program, there's no better time for you to make the switch. Next Tech Wireless, now offering nationwide 4G LTE.
I like our DVR because it works in every room. The HD looks great for sports, and I like how easy it is to rent on-demand movies. But the best thing about Next Tech TV is that we try to do even more than what our customers would expect to make sure their experience is great. I'm Joe, Next Tech Engineering Technician. Our products and our people are here for you.
Looks great. Hey, welcome back to Local Flavor and our Spitzbuben cookies. Did I say it right?
You did.
Okay. I'm standing here and you'll probably think that I rolled this out so beautifully, but the truth is it was really hard. And so during the break, I asked Tricia to help me out a little bit. So she rolled it out. What do you think, about a quarter of an inch?
Yeah, we try to make it a quarter of an inch because at the end you'll sandwich two cookies together with the jelly in between it and you don't want one huge cookie. So you try to do thin sides.
She's letting me do the fun part, though.
Yep.
Pressing the cookie press. I haven't done this since a long time.
She thinks it's fun.
Let's see here.
Oh, well, I also try to get as much cookie dough. Since it was so hard to roll out, don't waste any, okay?
Okay. But you get to eat the trim.
Yeah, you do get to eat the trim. I like to make them so they are...
Oh, look at you. And mine is right in the way, so you messed
up
your
diamond.
Yeah,
that's what I was meaning. There we go. See? So you get as many in a row as possible because the diamond works so well together when you do one after another.
Okay, awesome. Now, are these going to be stuck to the, is it yet to be seen?
To the counter?
Uh-huh.
Possibly. That's why we have our little spatulas here, and we're going to dip them in flour, cut away the outsides, and see how sticky they are. The countertops are pretty nice, so I think they'll probably be fine on it, but... They're kind of delicate to handle when you pick them up as well.
Well, once again, this is harder than I thought it was going to be.
It's like a geometry lesson.
I'm really wanting to get my Argyle socks out from my from back in the day.
Those are nice.
Doesn't it look like?
Yes.
Argyle sweater, Argyle socks, surely.
Maybe we should rename them to the Argyle cookie.
Yeah.
Instead of
hey,
Spitzbuben.
Yeah, because that also sounds Argyle mini pies.
Mini pies. There we go. Once Deb puts some of these on the sheet, I'll let you know that we also take some egg yolk. We separate it, get rid of the whites. It's only two egg yolks that we whisk up with a fork here. Add just a touch of milk. Not to the stove on purpose. Whisk that up. And after we put them on the cookie sheet, we'll put this egg wash over the cookies as well.
Are you trying to hurry me? We can put some on.
Yeah, you can put some on.
Look, I got the pattern though. Look at that. That looks great. I'm awesome.
Let's see how sticky they are. Can you pick any of them up?
With my hands?
Yeah, eventually, with the spatula.
Will you do this?
Here, let's see.
My hand is wet. Oh, clear out the way. I might be able to fit another one in that.
Oh, I'm sure we probably would, sorry.
Oh, very good. Now, is this treated? Did you already tell us? Is that got, like, spray on it?
Nope, it's just a plain old cookie sheet.
You didn't
have
to?
Anything on it.
Because there's so much butter in this, it won't
That's
stick.
Right, it won't stick to anything.
Except for this.
Right, as you're rolling them out, and that does get warmer, it gets a little more sticky and harder to handle. I'll give you that back and start spreading the egg yolk on them.
I feel like I'm changing the shape of them.
I kind of do too, but they're handmade creations, right? They're all supposed mm-hmm. to be individual and unique. So, whoops, I moved that one around.
Now, I wasn't listening. What did you put on that?
That's this is eggs? The egg. It's two egg yolks, or just egg yolk, and you mix a little milk in it just to make it more easy to spread.
Is this to give it a crustiness?
Yeah, just give it a little color to it almost at the top. Although at the end we will cover them with powdered sugar, but yeah, it gives it a little texture with the egg yolk, and then we'll put breadcrumbs. Is what comes next.
You know, this just feels like, just doing it, it feels like something you should be doing with your grandma and your aunt and your, maybe your mom gets a break, but.
Yeah, no, mom and I did this, grandma and I have done this. This was always my job, the smearing of the egg yolk and the.
Is that why you wouldn't let me do it?
Okay. You can do it, go for it. I think that's probably. Is that all?
This is a, like, do you make these by yourself, or is it a two-person task?
It's much easier with two people, but I have made them by myself. Friends, you know, who love them and everything. Well, that's talent right there. That's all that is. Friends love them, and I've made them for some people to buy at Christmas time or around the holidays or just whenever.
Because they didn't want to mess with it.
They don't want to mess. And it is kind of labor-intensive, but really it's not any, look what I did. It's not any odd ingredients, it's...
Yeah, they're simple recipes.
It's just stuff that you've all heard of and can find.
You probably like doing it more than the average Joe, just because it brings back memories for you, though.
Yeah, it does. I enjoy it.
What do these... Are these Christmas cookies? Are these any kind of holiday or just any time?
Just any time you want to light up your oven, I guess, and make a cookie.
Oh, this one's
And you have
great.
Time for it.
I don't know about this one.
We do, in my family, mainly make them around the holidays. So we'll put this in the oven. They bake at 350 degrees. Oh, got three more left I haven't done. Four. 350 degrees for about 10 to 12 minutes, depending on how your oven cooks. And, of course, you want them to be kind of a light golden brown.
Okay, you might have already said this. These are breadcrumbs.
Yes, just breadcrumbs. Plain breadcrumbs I bought at the store.
No salt, no Italian
Nothing,
seasoning.
Nothing, just plain.
Okay.
Everything plain.
Awesome. So you're going to put those in 350 degrees, and we have some already.
And we have some that I've prepared prior.
They do have a little bit of golden color from that egg.
They get golden from the egg.
It looks like frosting, but it's an egg yolk, so don't be
Now we'll finish them with, we have some apple-flavored jelly to put in between them, and I have a knife for you, too, so there you go. So you want to find the ones that kind of match up well and do, you know, a nice little sandwich cookie. So you can
do it on the naked side?
Yes, the underside, I'll see.
What flavor? Any flavor?
Any flavor. I've had people who actually make jalapeno jelly, put those in there. Ooh. I don't know if that's something I would eat in a pastry. This is apple, like I was saying.
Am I putting enough?
Yeah, perfect.
I'm usually pretty.
But Mom always said, not close to the edges. You don't want it to squish out.
Oh, that's going to be hard for me because I am a right to the edge kind of gal.
That's why we have apple, though, because it doesn't, you can't see it as well. No one will ever
if
know.
If it squeezes out.
It's clear. No one will ever know.
Doyle always makes the garlic toast. He puts the butter on, and I go back and
spread it further. Spread it thinner. Spread it more even. Oh, but it really doesn't matter. It all melts.
That's right.
Ooh, I think I got too much on this one.
That's going to be a good one.
Test the squeeze out.
Here we go. So we have a few up there. Do we want to go ahead and powder sugar them?
I'm going to finish them.
Okay, we'll finish them all.
You do what you want.
I'm following you.
You could have different jellies and everyone could get a surprise flavor in it.
That's a good idea. They're going to have these for like baby reveal parties pretty soon where you don't know what flavor the jelly is.
Oh my goodness. It's always something.
Whoops. Oh, I'm sorry.
Broken one. I'll taste this one later.
Okay, that's yours.
Put it close to me.
But apple, grape, peach, every kind of jelly.
Yeah, and all this work, and now we have half as many cookies as we started
That's
with.
That's a good point. That's an excellent point. You think you have all these dozens of cookies, but you sandwich them up, and you only have half. The finishing touch after you get all of your Spitzbuben smeared with a jelly or jam is we powder sugar the both sides of them.
Now, these look familiar.
Do they? With the powdered sugar on them?
Lots of cookies have powdered sugar on them. Is that my broken one?
I don't know. We can flip them, though.
Do both sides.
I do both. Yes. All the powdered sugar you can handle.
any more steps you can possibly add.
There we go. These are not the no-bake cookies.
No, definitely not.
I'm anxious to try this. I was nervous about the other stuff, but I didn't see anything scary going here.
No, it's all natural.
You try one, too.
I will. I won't want to inhale, though, with powdered sugar. I'll end up choking.
These are really good.
Little pastries.
It is. It's more like a pie crust than a sugar cookie or a spritz cookie. I mean, it's in that same kind of family, but it has more of a pie crust flavor. So I think it'd be essential to keep the jelly in it to keep the sweetness up.
Very good. I love these.
Mm. Okay. So, sorry to have my mouth full. I couldn't help it but take another bite. These are the Spitzbuben cookies. You can find the recipes for both this and the green bean dumpling soup online, on screen, or on YouTube. So you can watch us again on YouTube. Catch us on Local One, Next Tech Local One. And we'll see you again next time on Local Flavor. Thanks, Trisha.
Thank you for having me.